Okay.
Set-wise is fine. I think grip pressure we discussed. A little bit more in the fingers in terms of the pressure is fine, but don't be squeezing down the thumb. Okay. You want to be loose, but at the same time be secure. Yeah. Okay. Now these two movements are going to look fairly similar-ish. And we're just going to discuss what we're trying to do, obviously, from here.
Yeah.
Top of the back stream, you're good. First, when there's a bit of a drop and that right shoulder comes forward. I mean, there now, your shoulders are probably square about there.
Yeah.
And that club now we can see is a little bit out in front here. When you come to the golf ball, you're coming at the golf ball with the shoulders, everything going in this direction. So you've got to try and hold the face back and hold it open, which is going to just weaken your shot.
Yeah.
Okay. What we've got to try and do from here is feel the right shoulder sort of staying back and going down this way a little bit more.
Yeah.
So if you come into position here now, the club you can see now, bit more down the target line. Shoulders are still back slightly as we come in. The club's coming from a better direction here now. Again, lovely strike of the golf ball, and we can then twist through, keeping the arms and the body working in sync. If the shoulder gets a bit lungy over the top, you've then got to make a compensation, which when you're playing well, or you've got loft in your hand, or you're in enough shots in a row, you get away with it. When you haven't and you've got to hit a 5-iron one every 10 minutes, that timing's slightly off, and then you see your golf ball's going over here.
Yeah.
You look one over there somewhere, one over there, and you're sort of just going left, right, all over the place, trying to adjust to every single shot you've got.
So we're looking for more to bring it down.
Yeah, so the feeling from here now is the arm is going to drop in some ways. So that weight we had there, so the club working more down this way as we hit it, the club is just going to naturally fall backwards anyway because you're going to weight on the end. That's going to happen. I'm going to worry about that.
No.
Okay, get that club back now down nicely in line here, as we can see. So the shoulders now at impact, you can see they're just slightly open there, okay?
Head not too far down?
No, it's not too far. No, it's your right shoulder's coming in. Perceive that the angles are pretty good in terms of your spine, so nothing to worry about that, I'd say. But yeah, as we come back in, we want to try and ideally get the shoulders to be square impact. They're nearly square there. Yeah. They're not going to go complete from where they were to where they are, but keep those shoulders going through a little bit less if we can, and the hands and arms can swing through. So when the body swings less, there's more energy in the ball because the club's swinging quicker rather than you lunging
like
the body.
The finish with the right
That's good. That's really, exactly, The thing is, if you lunge that right shoulder, all your weight then goes forward, then your body's got to stop, your arms pull past, and your foot jumps forward and you lose your balance. You see, the sequence, and the swing then looks faster because you're just losing control.
Yeah.
It's not too fast, it's just out of sequence, okay?
So
feel the arm dropping, the shoulder's going to stay back.
The big thing I'm going to get me at is drop it down.
Just feel that, just feel everything from the top of the back and kind of coming from here and just sort of feeling this when we come in, like you would do, say, hitting a tennis racket, sort of.
Exactly.
We'll come in.
Thank
good
you,
stuff,
Gareth.
Well done.